It happens every year. We'll eat a lot of broccoli and drink a lot of beer. You should be good and happy that there's someone you can eat. A million people every day are starving in the street. Your daddy's in the gutter with the wretched and the poor. Your mama's in the kitchen with a can of Cycle 4. There's garbage in the water, there's poison in the sky. I guess it won't be long before we're all gonna die. Happy birthday! Happy birthday! Friend, you think this party is the best? Enjoy it while you can. We'll soon be blown to bits. The monkeys in the Pentagon are gonna cook our goose. The fingers on the button, all they need is an excuse. It's also take a bit of their genius to see. We'll all be crispy critters after World War III. There's nowhere you can run to, nowhere you can hide. When they drop the big one, we all get fried.
Come on, boys and girls, sing along, okay?
Happy birthday! Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday! Happy birthday! Buying everything inside. There's a mother in the ghetto with another mouth to feed. Seems that everywhere you look today there's misery and greed. I guess you know the earth is gonna crash into the sun. But that's no reason why we shouldn't have a little fun. So if you think it's scary, if it's more than you can take, just blow out the candles and have a piece of cake. Happy birthday! Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday! Happy birthday to you!
Wow! John, hi, it's Jeff. Sorry I can't be there, but seriously, are you really having a party to celebrate 43 years? I mean, 43 is absolutely nothing. They don't even make a birthday card for a 43rd birthday. No one except a depressed, lonely man has a party on his 43rd birthday. I mean, is there anything more meaningless than a 43rd birthday? This isn't a celebration, it's a cry for friendship. 43. How pathetic is that? That's 3 years after a midlife crisis and 7 years before your first colonoscopy. John, I have to tell you, it sounds to me like a desperate attempt to get everyone you've ever met into one room on the same night. I mean, your wife dumped you, you can't get a date, and your phone sex service went out of business. So why not send a mass online invitation to everyone in your database? 43. That's about as meaningful as graduating from preschool. I can just imagine this conversation between you and your teacher. Little Johnny, what did you learn this year? Teacher, I learned how to wee-wee in the big white bowl. Whoa, give that kid a certificate and send him off to kindergarten. John, I'm sorry I can't be there to join you for this less than momentous occasion. But with gas prices the way they are, it would cost me about $20 to drive to Pleasanton and back. And quite frankly, a 43rd birthday party is just not worth it. Seriously, John, have a great birthday. Let me know when you'll be celebrating something that means something, like another divorce. And I'll be there. Love ya.
And I don't even like to tell people about this. It was so freaking hot last night. I called my ex-wife, and she came over, and we slept together. Woo! And it's not what you're thinking. I just needed the cold chill. So she helped me out. That's all I'm saying. And I'll tell you a little bit about myself for those of you who don't know me. I've lost some weight, but what a lot of people don't realize is I'm actually a bulimic. Right. Thank you. And, you know, people, they look at me, they're like, well, how could you be a bulimic, right? I'm like, I only throw up the healthy stuff. See, I like it when only three people laugh, because you know that's a good joke. It's not commercial, you're kind of thinking. So I, here's an interesting fact about my birthday. I was born in 1965, the same year the Slurpee was invented. For those of you, and here's how the Slurpee was invented, for those of you who don't know. It was actually an accident, and it was a result of a broken soda fountain machine. And so that's how the Slurpee was invented, which is coincidental because I was the result of a broken condom. I did not even know they made a book like this. It's called Masturbation for Dummies. I know, two masturbation jokes in a minute. No, seriously. But actually, this book was only 2 pages. And the first page just talked about left hand, right hand, and both hands. Right? And you know what's on page 2?
What?
Beats me.
Oh!
So I got John a present. It's actually something I found in Alaska. It's a four-leaf clover. It's one of the biggest ones I've ever found.
Wow.
I'm like a Jewish leprechaun. I have this ability to find four-leaf clovers. And John, I hope this clover will help you get lucky in the next year. Pay attention!
John,
I'm talking to you! This is for you, so you can get lucky in the next year. It's a real four-leaf clover.
Take it.
Happy birthday.
Take it.
We're so I have to, okay, so this is gonna be a weird thing to publicly admit, but I actually had a little bit of a crush on John when I first met him.
Woo!
I have really weird standards. And John, who is not paying attention to me, he sort of hits my trifecta of what I like in a guy.
All right.
I like him chubby, I like him schlubby, and if he's got a monotone voice, all the better. And John, when he talks, he makes Ben Stein sound like Gilbert Godfrey.
That's okay.
Can you imagine him, like what he says during sex? This is what I have to talk about. Oh, baby. I'm on fire. I like it when you touch me there.
Let's see. Okay, our next comic, a very funny guy, plays all over the Bay Area. He's a favorite out there. And as I'm doing to everybody that comes up tonight, if hilarity were an AA meeting, I'd do them with a bunch of alcoholics. Give it up for Kenny Altman.
All right. All right.
Let me talk about the toughest crowd I ever played. About 8 months ago, I bombed in front of a group of 100 Jewish senior citizens. Yeah, why are you applauding for that? My people turned on me! My people! They hated me. Oh my God, they hated me. They were taking the tennis balls off the bottom of their walkers and throwing them at me. They're throwing the walkers at me. These crazy fucking Jews, man, let me tell you. They hated me so much, they were throwing meat and dairy at me at the same time.